So the next topic is here, that is the Wells factor. It is the stresses in the stresses for regarding this helical gear. It is the shear stress which is acting based on the effect. So the maximum stress induced in the wire, shear stress induced in the wire is depend on this Ks into 8WD divided by pi d cube. This equation we get here. So the shear stress factor was what? 1 plus 1 by 2C. Now from this above equation, this for a small spring index C, we have neglected the effect of curvature wire here. But if you are going to see this, that if you are going to consider the curvature effect, what will happen? So the one person was that Wells, Mr. Wells has introduced this factor, that is Wells factor. Due to that, we can consider the curvature effect. So the effect of wire curvature may be neglected because yielding of the material will relieve the stresses. In order to consider the effect of both direct shear stress as well as the curvature effect, a Wells factor should be introduced. A.M. Wells has introduced this factor. So in this factor, a simple thing is there. Instead of Ks, we have to use K. So K is what? 4 times C minus 1 divided to 4 times C minus 4 plus 0.615 by C. So instead of Ks, we have to use K for considering the curvature effect. And the figure shows that the effect of curvature effect. The stress factor K is here. So as the spring index increases, the stress factor reduces. So this is how it has been done. So from the figure, the Wells factor increases very rapidly as the spring index decreases. The spring mostly used in machinery have spring index above 3. Okay, so the Wells stress factor K may be considered as composed of two sub factor, that is Ks and Kc. Ks is the stress factor due to shear and Kc is the stress concentration factor due to curvature. This is how it is done. So I think you understand this part. Okay, thank you.